preaching, a man don't work. And you know, I'm standing there. And then every week when my wife got paid off, she'd take out the money for the bill, she'd give me $20. That was my line, $20. $20. And so I believe in the number 7, completion, perfection, release. And so I take out $7, put in a tithe. And they saw me just paying $7 tithe. That was over than what I was getting. $7. They just kept preaching, man, don't eat. I start feeling so bad because of my paying on the bills. She got to go to secondhand stores, match up stuff. But when she go match it up, you think she done went to Billings or something. She just got to pick up stuff. And so after 3 months, I start crying to God. I said, God, I just can't do this. Too much pressure. And all the pastor's wife, minister wife come to church and testifying that they fly to Atlanta, Georgia.
Yeah.
My clothes come back there. My wife sitting there hearing all these testimonies, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And every time one of the minister wives get the mic, testify how they flew Saturday morning to Atlanta and did some shopping and flew back Saturday evening. They got all, you know, went all these, you know what I'm talking about, but my wife said no, I said, after 3 months, I went back to work. And I told her, I said, I'm going to pay the bill. You ain't never got to pay a bill with your check. So I gave her that freedom. And now, thank you, Jesus. I ain't bragging, but the proof is in the pudding. And then she, after the Lord started blessing me, my mom did, she said, baby, we ain't going to never have that. So why are you saying that? Oh, you give everything away. But I learned the principle. I learned what salvation is all about. Giving. You can't be stingy and be a Christian. After God gave his best. And really, he didn't give his best, he gave himself. And you really look at it, he gave himself. The demon must back up to him. And I in the message of salvation, God always challenges us. And if you believe God, you ought to stand up to the challenge.
Yeah, amen.
Some of us, we don't sow. You got this soul, man. That's what it's all about. What you think, God? He sowed one soul. Look at all of the sons he got. And then I'm old farmer. I was raised up on the farm. And I know by sowing plant seed, you don't put no seed in the ground, don't go out there looking for no harvest. And I understand when we used to plant a bean seed, it takes 60 days for that bean seed to come up, and in 60 days we pick it. Pepper take 90 days, eggplants to take 90 days. So we knew within those 60 days in bean, we got to cultivate, we got to fertilize, we got to pull the weeds around, and all that. So it won't nothing hinder that seed. And so when you sow, you can't let doubt come, because it's going to hinder your seed. See, a farmer went out and planted a seed, but at night the devil went and planted tear to choke. See, when somebody said like that, girl, why you keep sowing all them seeds? They trying to choke you. Come on now. It caused you to be weary. You got to sow and be glad.
Yes.
Serve the Lord with gladness, not with sadness and madness.
Wow.
You got to sow and be glad you did it. And then as soon as you sow, two weeks later, you got a final notice. But you still rejoice off that seed you sow. Because if the seed that you sow will never leave your life, and it's going to take care of everything. But if you don't sow nothing, you don't get nothing. Amen. Thank you, Apostle. Man, I'm so glad I met you. And what a friend. What a friend.
Amen.
Amen. Now, we get ready for one of the biggest services ever came through South Florida.
Amen.
It's going to be June the 13th. We have about 40 pastors, maybe more, that we have came together. And every 3 months, we're going to do a big service. The first service is going to be here. It's going to be June the 13th. We're going to start at 6 o'clock. It's good time. So we're going to be out by 8:30, no more than 8:45. So nobody have an excuse about Sunday morning service. Because you know, we'll pull the excuse quick. that kept me in church all Saturday night. Pastor Noah ain't coming Sunday morning. We want to get you out early. So even if you stay in 3:05, you can be back home by 9:30. Thank you, Jim. I'm going to give it back to the apostle. Thank God for these skillful musicians. Anointed singers. We thank God for these anointed voices, anointed.